Lozano was a huge comeback for LaSalle, where they nailed back the series to force the game on Sunday. We go straight into the press room. Our friends from the media, our friends from the press, and of course, the winning side right now with us. Simulan na natin kay Assistant Coach Miggy. Coach Ronnie.
Coach Miggy here. Coach Miggy, you were down by as much as 21. Nothing was going right. Ateneo was doing everything correct. What was going through your mind during that instance? Parang na for personal response pa si Richie Rivero. Parang naulit na naman yung nangyari doon sa game 1.
Well, actually, the first quarter, it's medyo gigil yung mga players. So we realized half of the second quarter that we really need to contain them, because almost all of their points are coming from transition. So yun, nakinig naman yung mga players, and they really did well in containing the, lalo na si Matt Nieto, and yung buti na lang, it went our way.
So you were talking about the blow bys for the San Jose, not pressure defense in game one. What for you? What was the turning point? The main reason why you were able to erase a 21-point disadvantage, eventually win by this big versus the Ateneo team.
Well, part of one thing is more. I think yung discipline on defense really did gamble more on the second half, and buti na lang talagang we played with heart on the second half in the last 2 minutes of the second quarter.
Thank you. Alright, so ipanan mo natin si Richie Boom Gonzalez. Kamusta? Anong pakiramdam mo yan? Patapos na ng laro, natulas ka pa, anong masama yung bansa? How do you feel right now? Let's start with that first.
Siyempre happy, pero yun nga, like what Coach said, don't celebrate unless parang it's finished na. So yun, siguro hindi kami mag-stop na mag-work for next game, and we offer namin everything to God.
Alright. The first half, 4 personal fouls. We got emotional, you know, nakita na natin yung mga scenes, and I'm sure we're going to see it all over social media. What happened? There's a moment with you and your brother. There's a moment on the bench. Anong inisip mo nun? Bakit ka naging emotional? Is it because you couldn't contribute anymore? Feeling mo ba hindi ka na makapabalik sa laro? At paano nag-turn around yan yung second half, yung pinalik ka midway in the third quarter?
Siguro, yun lang. Parang sinabi ng brother ko na, yun nga, that wasn't me, and kailangan maglaro ako na yung ako lang, yung hang loose na parang relax and all, hindi yung gigil. Tapos yung second half, siguro, it wasn't me who played. Siguro, that was God, kasi the whole time na nasa bench ako, I was praying lang na parang siya yung gumawa ng turning point para manalo kami and makatulong ako, and siguro magawa ko yung gusto ni Coach in a good way.
I'm sure the follow-up question lang, Richie, for you. Have you ever played before na meron ka ng 4 fouls? Second quarter pa lang?
Siguro, bata po.
Bata ka pa naman eh.
Alright,
let's go to Ben Ebana. I think he's right beside Richie. Ben, first of all, congratulations on the MVP once again. Back-to-back MVP. Congratulations on the win. The run. You were down 21. The run started with that dunk almost at the end of the second quarter. It started a 10-0 run, and then it went on to the third quarter. We asked Coach Miggy what we're watching that dunk right now. We're asking Coach Miggy what was the turnaround for him and the coaching staff. For you, you were there on the floor, offensively, defensively. What changed for LaSalle at that moment?
I say we stick together. We saw some of our players down, struggling. We didn't give up. We kept playing D. We kept pushing. Coach kept on telling us to keep playing, to keep believing. Because as a team, we've been through, almost the same situation this year against Anderson. So I feel like we got used to games like this, and we should stick together. We stick to the game plan, and, you know, we did what Coach asked us to do, play D, and from there we started everything.
Coach Ronnie, you know, you promised to come out more aggressive here in game number two. You said already that, you know, it got to your head in game number one. Obviously, we all know the numbers already and what happened. In the first quarter, it was still like that. You still had problems against the defense, obviously the fouls. How did you turn it around?
Well, something I always have to remind myself is, at the end of the day, it's a game. And when it's a game, you have to enjoy it. And I feel like for the past game, I haven't been enjoying the game. I was too tense. You know, I wanted to overdo everything. And I had to, like, sit down, inhale, exhale, and, you know, relax.
Right.
That's what I tried doing. And then maybe after that dunk, I feel like everything went smoothly. And everything started going on for us.
Yeah. I have another question for you. You have played Ateneo dating back to season 79. That will be already about 7 weeks. Into this year, what is the hardest part about playing the Ateneo League, especially in the biggest stage, the finals?
Well, when you play Ateneo, there's no underdog, there's no one having the upper hand, you know. Everyone can blow you out, everyone can, you know, be like a champion. So when you have to go there, you have to give your everything. The crowd is crazy and, you know, everyone wants to win it. Everyone is dying for the ball. And it's pretty crazy, but you still have to find a way to stay focused and do whatever you have to do.
All right. Andre, karakot naman our best player of the game. Andre, ito na yung pinakamagandang laro mo against Ateneo this year. Nabigyan ka ng pagkakataon dito in game number two. Kwento mo sa amin, ano yung pakiramdam, ano yung nangyari, anong magandang nangyari para sa'yo, magandang ginawa mo dito sa game.
Siguro, madami ang tagaw.
Katulad na?
Alam ba ni Baser yan?
Ayun niya, habang ilalaro ko, parang, di ba yung feeling eh, pag alam mo nakikita mo yung mga teammates mo na down, parang ayaw ko na may mawala sa amin pag matalo kami. So, start sa, di ko alam kung anong run niya ko sa third quarter, second quarter, sabi ko, basta kailangan, gayahin ako ng mga teammates. Start ako ng defense. Ayun lang. Ginawa ko lang lahat para sa teammates ko and sa community.
Kayo ni Kib yung talagang trumabaho pagdating sa defense, sa ball pressure, na pagiging unselfish, na pagbibigay ng bola sa mga kasama mo. Pero para sa'yo, nung time na lamang na lamang natin ngayon, at hindi sila mapinilan at napakaingay ng blue side, ano yung nasa isip mo ng mga oras na yun? Dahil bilis ng labang eh. At napakahirap tumako lalong lalo na also against a very good na highly disciplined team.
First quarter pa naman yung labang nila, so sabi ko haba pa ng oras. And yung tiwala ko sa defense ko, hindi talaga mawawala. Siguro yan. Tras, hindi mawawala. Kaya siguro, nanalo ko.
Alright. Congratulations, Andre. Congratulations to Ben and Richie. Sana pagaling ka. Sana hindi sa'yo also. Coach Biggie, thanks again for your time, as always, whether it's now or during halftime. And you want to tune out to us on the
mom. Let's say, we have to ask questions. And the second question, now you got this first win in the finals. Can you promise us for game two?
You know, coming to game two, we're not coming here to lose the game. Everyone wants to be champion. It's not like we're going to go out there and be like, oh, you won the game, I got an MVP, that's it. No, we are here to be champion. That's what we're going to work for. And we're going to come out here to try to grab that trophy.
You got any questions?
When was that Ramsey in the
fourth? Yeah, lately in the fourth, I was kind of cramping up. You know, the final, we got to play through it. Have to look for excuses or reasons. So I was there for the team and luckily I was able to finish the game. I got shy.
Go.
medyo may gigil pa kasi syempre, yung medical type ka, na ka ng medical type ka, diba? Last year, nagigil especially for some of that.
Siguro yung gigil, it's not about getting awards or what. Siguro parang, yun, hindi kasi sobrang minsan ako naka-finals and even high school around experiences. So, siguro yung willingness mo to win, tapos sobrang hype ng Ateneo Lasal, tapos finals siya, and game 2. So, yun, parang, nandun talaga yung gigil if, parang, alam mo yung hindi ka pa used dun sa ganung situation.
Hindi pa kayo natatalo sa Araneta. Are you enjoying playing here? Especially na Ben. Yeah, you Ben.
Yes, of course. I'm enjoying playing here, you know. I love my team, I love my teammate, I love the Philippines, and you know, I love the fans. I'm enjoying the game. You know, people are nice to me here, and you know, I'm trying to turn back to FIBA by, you know, giving my everything out there during every single